Greetings, ladies and gentlemen, and we welcome you to Interesting Ideas. And for many of you in the United States, this is a very important day. It's a holiday. It means most of you don't have to go to work. You have the day off, and you can spend your time, you know, enjoying it, you know, going on a picnic, you know, having family over, making a trip. It really is kind of the celebration of the end of summer and the beginning of the autumn season, where we're back to school and back to work. So it is kind of a special, important day. And I'm reminded of a man who looked me straight in the eye along with others and said, "You might as well enjoy the coming Labor Day, because we will not have class and school on that day. However, after this year, you will never have a holiday off." That's right. You will never have a holiday off. So this may be your last holiday off. Enjoy it. Well, that's part of the story, and it's also part of what we're going to do, as the title said. God bless the accountants, bless the bartenders, bless the cooks. And let's find out what that could mean. I'm Stan Houston. These are a few random thoughts for the Labor Day. Hopefully they'll be helpful to you, and that program begins right now. Okay, here we go. What had happened is many, many years ago, I had decided that I was going to make a career change. I had been a teacher for many years, and I enjoyed teaching. However, I realized that my service in the public schools and doing what I was doing and doing it where I was doing was not what I really wanted to do the rest of my life. And with that change in mind, I went back to what are some of your first loves, and I had always loved radio. I was a ham radio operator. I listened to the radio. I love shortwave radio. And so I talked to my wife, and we made a decision. I was going to go back to night school because I had a full-time day job, and I was going to learn how to be a radio broadcaster. And so I signed up to do that, and that was in the summer of 1977. Yep. Signed up then. And we were at it. And because it was night school, we began classes at 6 o'clock and it went till 10 o'clock. It was because most of the people in the night school, of course, were like me. They already had a full-time day job. And so for them to be able to make it into the radio business, they had to go to night school. And so we were. And I remember, obviously, at about this time, we'd been at it since July, you know, July and we August, and now, of course, we're 2 months into the class, and the instructor came down and told us all. He said, "By the way, we will not have class on Monday. We will not have class on Labor Day. We will all celebrate the holiday here at Brown Institute of Broadcasting." But then he said, "But remember, this is your last holiday." He said, "Now that you're in the radio business, there are no such things as holidays. If the radio station is on the air and you are scheduled to work that day, you will work that day. Yes, Christmas, New Year's, 4th of July, and Labor Day. Any of the days that everybody else gets the holiday off, that does not work for you. Perhaps somebody will just luckily find that the holiday comes on their scheduled day off, but other than that, you'll go to work." And you know what? That's exactly the way it worked out. That's what I did. And so there are times when obviously I got up very, very early on Christmas morning, and while the rest of the family was celebrating all of the Christmas days, I was at the radio station doing the program. That's just the way it was. And that's important. That's important to know because, you know, I'm not the only one who had to work on holidays. Of course, you all know that. There are thousands, millions of people who holidays are just another day at work. Somebody has to be in the police car. Somebody has to be at the hospital. Somebody has to be in those places that, well, we just need someone there to make things work. And so we honor those people who have those kinds of jobs on Labor Day. And so I do that. I do that profoundly. And I know what it's like now that I'm obviously somewhat self-employed and have my own business. But you know what? I still choose. Here I am. I'm doing this live on Labor Day just so I remember that there are people who work on the holiday. And more important, I also have come to more and more appreciate just the importance. And I'm going to talk more about that this week. As I shared with you, we have to have leaders, but we also have to have laborers. And a society that doesn't have good leaders and good laborers is in deep trouble. And I'm happy to see that maybe we're even beginning to discover that, because I'm going to talk about the fact that more and more we have to encourage people, young people, to understand, no, college and university may not be the way. In fact, there are probably, in terms of the fact that we are trying to prepare for a good career or a good job, there are probably far better ways to do that than spend thousands, maybe hundreds of thousands of dollars going to college or university. And so we'll be talking about some of the interesting ideas as the schools are starting in many parts of at least North America during this September beginning. During this, right after Labor Day, it's back to work and back to school. And I was deeply moved by something that came across from the Institute for Faith, Work, and Economics today. It was called A Labor Day Prayer, If We Dare. And it's written by a gentleman named John Pletcher. John Pletcher. So I want to make sure he gets full attribution for this. And this is what he wrote. And so with your permission, may I kind of perform it. Throughout the years, I've noticed a mischievous thing about Labor Day weekend. If I'm not careful, I miss it. You know, I can get so caught up in the sensational hoopla of picnics, yard work, or a last hurrah of summer getaways and going to the lake that I mindlessly skip over the holiday's true significance. Might we dare to think, stir, and move a step or two deeper this year on the meaning and the opportunity of Labor Day and the weekend? And maybe we should learn to say a prayer. Here's where he goes. The history of Labor Day, originally Labor Day, was so much more than a calendar marker to wrap up summer, the pools closing, and the launch of all the things flavored pumpkin spice. The call for such a day was the creation of the labor movement, and it was dedicated to recognizing the social and economic achievements of American workers. So it constitutes a yearly national tribute to the contributions of workers, laborers, who have made to the strength, prosperity, and well-being of our country. Now, the first state bill for Labor Day was introduced in the New York legislature, but the first to become law was passed by Oregon on February the 21st, 1887. During that year, four more states, Colorado, Massachusetts, New Jersey, and New York, created the Labor Day holiday by legislative enactment. By the end of the decade, Connecticut, Nebraska, and Pennsylvania had followed suit. By 1894, 23 other states had adopted the holiday in honor of workers, and on June 28th of that year, Congress passed an act making the first Monday in September of each year a legal holiday in D.C., the states, and the territories. Yes. Now, how about a Labor Day prayer, if we dare? And I think we do dare. Let's remember just how important it is. And you caught my title. Yes. Let's, dear God, bless the accountants, the bartenders, and the cooks. People who actually do hard work. I'm afraid we too often forget just how meaningful and significant our daily work is in the scope of God's original call to humans. Genesis 1:2, and his ongoing plan for present-day disciples, those of us who follow Jesus, actively grow in holistic faith. There's a thought-provoking, responsive prayer that was penned by Jim Cotter and Paul Payton. And then he goes on to say that they have now decided that on the Sunday before Labor Day, they actually are now having special prayers for the laboring people, the people who labor. Now, we pray, of course, for doctors, and we pray for nurses, and we pray for firemen and policemen and first responders. We even pray for politicians and leaders. But do we ever pray for those who go to work and make our world better? Well, this is what they did. They actually have put together what I would call a prayer and a praise response, where you say a blessing, and then you say the people who have been blessed, they are to respond in praise to God. So, let's just take a few minutes to think about that. And actually, I'll share the Labor Day prayer that Jim Cotter and Paul Payton put together. That's coming up. Boy, another interesting idea. You are in tune. My name is Stan Houston. These are interesting ideas. We come your way, and we are here to help you as you do your work and do as you do your labor, that it will go better for you and that you will be indeed not only really good at what you do, but you will be able to be a blessing to others in what you do. That's just part of the reason we do what we do. We'll be back. All right, here we go. We're going to start praying for those people who work. Let the sowers of seed bless you, great God. The gardeners and farmers sing your praise. May the fishers and foresters bless you, praise your name, and glorify you forever. Let the bread makers from grain bless you, great God. The bakers, the winemakers, the people who squash the grapes and make the wine, sing for you. Let the bartenders and baristas bless them as they do their work. May the transformation from cooks bless you. May the spinners and weavers be blessed by you, great God. The designers of clothes, bless them. May the salesmen and retailers be blessed and bless you. Let the sounds and silences of music bless you as it blesses us. Bless the great composers who sing your praise. May the improvisers of jazz bless you as they blow their horn and praise your name. Let the software and civil engineers bless you, great God. Let the architects sing your praise. Yes, of course, may the pastors and clergy bless you. But let the marketers and advertisers bless you and be blessed. Let the entrepreneurs sing your praise. Yes, even may the attorneys and the judges bless you. And let the educators and the teachers bless you, and the academics and the authors. May they sing your praise. May the doctors and nurses be blessed. May all of those who keep us well be blessed and bless you and praise your name and glorify you forever. For those who are the first responders who rescue us from danger, may they be blessed and bless you. Let the sculptors and scientists bless you, great God. The business owners and janitors, may they sing your praise. Yes, even may the artists and baristas bless you. May we all together bless you and sing your praise. I think it's just rather important for us to think about that. Whenever a car, ambulance, truck, ambulance, fire truck goes by, of course I pull over and I always say a little prayer. I don't know what's up, but something is up. And there are people who need to be prayed for and thought about. I also will tell you the story this week of somebody else who's very important. It's the story of a man I met who has a college degree. And he could have a lot of different jobs, but he has chosen to be a tow truck driver. Yes, he drives the tow truck. That's the work he does. And as he says, I'm on call 24/7. Doesn't matter. I'm on call 24/7. Well, there we are. I hope this has been helpful to you. Please, as we all go back to work, let us make sure that we don't begin to think that we're better than others, that some other work might be beneath us, that some work may be better and better to do than the work that others do. Let's just remember that all of us really can be worshipers through our work, and we can be people who bless others and serve others just through the work we do. Just a thought or two on Labor Day. Please stay with me. We'll do a lot of that this week, but we're also going to be talking about, again, if you have a voice, it's time to share your voice. Do the work. Think about doing that. As I said, we're also going to talk about other things and other programs, other opportunities, and I'm going to tell you a little bit about a podcast that we have on Route 66 and a program on classic old cars and on cowboys and the Wild West, all kinds of things that are now available for those of us who have unique and wonderful and hopefully creative and good interests. Thank you for your time. Please reach out to me because I can help you as you do your work in this coming fall quarter or wherever you are in your world where it may be the coming of spring. We can help you. Reach out to me at stanhusted@gmail.com, stanhusted@gmail.com. All the best and blessings to you because you always, always close with a benediction, whatever you do and whenever you do your work. You know, A, B, C, you know, accountants, bartenders, cooks, whatever you do, you know, A, C, B. Always close with a benediction. Take care. Bye for now.